Hoş geldin.
Bana vereyim mi?
Hoş geldiniz, buyurun.
What's up, everyone? I'm Chris. Steph's behind the camera. We're hungry to travel. It's a sunny but chilly day here in Izmir, and we're looking forward to a delicious day of eating. We're going to be starting our day off at a lokantasi where they have loads of different dishes to try. So we're going to go and see what kind of tasty things we can eat. Come on.
We're here at Esnaf Lokantasi, where we have a big spread of foods that we've never tried before and we are really excited to try. So we've got these lovely kofta in a yogurt sauce. We also got these dried chilies with yogurt, which this lokantasi is famous for. The lovely chef brought us over this keli pacha, which is a sheep's head soup to try. And then we also got this iskembe chickpea soup, which is a tripe soup. And on its way, we have a baked kokoreç coming, which this lokantasi is also really famous for. So we are dying to try that. It's gonna be fresh out the oven. Look at these kofta. Ooh, wow. So it's quite a very delicate and light, kind of thin, yogurty soup that they're in. Let's do it. Oh, wow. Mmm. Those lamb kofta are so tender. When you bite into it, it just melts in your mouth pretty much, probably because you're stewing in the yogurt soup. Mm. And the yogurt soup, oh, it's lovely and tangy. Mm. Look at that.
There's so much tripe in there, and it looks like lovely, lovely soft chickpeas. This looks good. Nice and hot. Nice soup for the morning. Mmm. The tripe is nice and chewy. Oh, nice and soft though. Look at the size of this piece of tripe here. Wow. Mmm. We have the keli pacha soup here. Look at all the meat in there. All the sheep's head meat, the cheek meat. Mmm. Mmm. Wow, the cheek meat just melts in your mouth. So soft and tender. These soups are so delicious. For breakfast, a soup is so nice and warming, especially today in Izmir, it's pretty cold, so this is nice.
I've got the chili and yogurt, which I'm really, really looking forward to trying. You can see the chilies are dried. Big chunks of dry chili that are just put right on top of the yogurt. Oh, look at that! Mmm. Mm. Oh. So at first, chili just is kind of dry chili. The more you chew it, you can feel the burn, but it's not too spicy. And the yogurt is lovely and creamy. Look at that! Mm-hmm. Chilies and yogurt, such a weird, different combination, but it totally, totally works. I can see why this is one of their specialties here, because these dried chilies are so nice.
So they just finished baking the baked kokoreç upstairs and brought it down. So here it is, it's piping hot. And this is really special here at Esnaf Lokantasi because they only make this baked kokoreç every Tuesdays and Fridays. And lucky for us, today is Friday, so we get to try it and it looks awesome. Oh wow, and right when I cut into it, so soft. Wow, just breaks apart. Look at that. Wow. Piping hot. Look how steamy that is. Right out of the oven. Wow. It's so soft. Kind of has like that, when you bite into liver, how it's just mushy almost, because it's baked just so nice and soft. Wow, that's really, really good. Give it a nice little dousing of cumin, because cumin always tastes so good with offal. Wow, and you can see the outside is nice and crispy. Crispy and crunchy. So tender. Kokoreç, chocolatezetli. So good.
As we were getting through our meal, the lovely chef Usta brought us over another something special to try. It looks like maybe bulgur with chickpeas and most likely some lamb meat. So, let's give it a try. That's so nice. The meat is so tender. And what I'm pretty sure is bulgur here is lovely and salty. The food here at Esnaf Lokantasi was amazing. They have so many really different and unique and interesting dishes than other Lokantasis we've seen. So I'm really, really glad that we came here. The hospitality has been amazing. We got to try a few different dishes that we didn't even order. So if you're on the Kemeralti Bazaar, you definitely have to come here to try the food. Every dish we had was amazing, so just try them all.
That was so good.
This is the perfect thing to warm us up on this chilly day today here in Izmir. This is so cool. You can see the boat is rocking, but we have such a beautiful view out onto the water. This is really, really cool. We haven't seen anything like this. So glad we stopped in to get warm. We're here at Zeyn El Ergun Gevrek Firin, where they specialize in gevrek. If you want to try gevrek in Izmir, this is the place you have to come to. Chris was just getting some shots of them making it, which looks really cool, and the Usta passed us some to try. They are piping hot, right fresh out the oven. Smells so good, like toasted sesame. Oh, look at these guys! Wow, so nice and warm. Gevreks are really similar to simit, which are pretty much like the grandfather of bagel. Except what makes them different is that simits are just kind of coated with molasses and sesame seeds before being put in the oven. Whereas gevreks, the dough is dipped in boiling hot molasses and kind of fried in it first before the sesame seeds go on top. And then they go in the oven, so it makes them a bit more kind of crispy. and crunchier than your typical simit, and they really, really are. You can just hear how crispy they are. It's so nice with the roasted sesame seeds. So this is like the kumru sandwich, except it just doesn't have the meat, but they make them here with the tomato and the cheese inside. Look at that, piping hot. Wow, look at that cheese inside. It's so melty. The bread is lovely and toasted. Wow, there's so much cheese actually in there. Wow, oh, look at all that cheese. Oh my gosh, so melty and fresh. You can smell the cheese. It's quite a strong smelling cheese actually. And so nice of them to just hand it to us out the window like that. This is delicious and awesome. What a fun, cool experience. That cheese is so good.
So cool.
Amazing. I'm just fascinated by how big that oven is and how far back it goes. That is so cool, but so nice of the Gebrek Usta to give us these. They're piping hot Gebreks to take with us. This is going to be a great snack later on in the day.
The oven goes so deep.
Wow. The lovely Gebrek team was watching me so intently, looking in the oven, trying to see what was going on, that they brought us over some lovely teas and some boyos to try. So it's really, really cool because they are pumping out the Gebreks and the little kumru sandwiches, but then you can also come to the other side and you can have tea, you can have boyos, and pretty much have the perfect Izmir breakfast here. So this is great for breakfast number two.
So we got two hot boyos here. Ooh, I think this is the kamali one. Oh, look at all that meat inside there. Wow. We can smell the kamali meat so much too. Pastry is nice and flaky. That's really yummy. A really meaty boyos. Let's see which one this one is. Ooh, I think this is the panerli cheese boyos. Ooh, look at all that cheese. Wow. Oh. So flaky and crispy actually. These boyos are so good for breakfast because they're super light but super filled with all the ingredients depending on which one you get. So yummy.
There's just a constant lineup and stream of people here getting their Gebrek fix. Gebrek team has been watching us over here eating our second breakfast, and they just brought us over, wow, this lovely chocolate. I don't even know what. It looks amazing. Let's just bust it open here. Oh my gosh. There's way more chocolate in there than I was expecting. It's almost like a Gebrek bomba. Oh my god. Just so rich and creamy. And actually really, really soft and light. The dough on the outside, it kind of reminds me of a like a croissant kind of dough. It's very, very light. Oh my god, look at that. With a little crisp to it as well. And seriously, packed with chocolate. Talk about a sugar kick now for our breakfast. This is amazing. Such a beautiful atmosphere here in the courtyard, getting to have your breakfast while watching the Gebrek team hard at work.
Chuck
Tishikular. Tishikular.
Wow, what an awesome and cool experience. I'm so glad we came here. As amazing and delicious as that was, our food adventure must continue. So come on, let's go.
We saw this salad container walking by and we thought we're gonna get some salad, so we got a nice big glass of it. It looks awesome, it's so steamy and hot. Sprinkled with cinnamon on top. Oh, it smells so good. Şerefe. Mmm. Yeah, it's so thick and creamy and milky. So salep's actually made from the roots of wild orchids. It almost has like an almondy flavor to me, but with the cinnamon on top, it's the perfect warm drink for a chilly day. Wow, look how thick that is. You can see just how thick the salep actually is. And that nice cinnamon on top. A good nice hot drink. To warm you up.
Such an interesting and vibrant city. We've been walking around lots today, so we are starting to get a bit hungry and are gonna head off for dinner. We're here at İzmir Manti Evi for manti, which they actually make by hand here, and it's kind of like a meat pasta. So while we're waiting for our fresh manti to arrive, we've ordered a few other things to try. We've got some lovely sarma here with yogurt sauce, yogurt dip, as well as the içil köfte, which we have not tried yet before. And what it is a stuffed meatball. And the outer casing, they're deep fried, so you can see it actually looks quite crunchy. I'm gonna put some lemon on it here. And it's like a fried bulgur dough and meat on the inside. So we've been dying to try these. Look at this little guy, how cute. Let's give it a shot. Wow, look at that. It looks like kind of red peppers. There's spices on the inside, so it's got a little bit of a kick to it. And the meat inside is really, really nice and tender. It's crunchy on the outside because it's been deep fried. And you can see it's kind of a bulgur type of a casing there. so it's kind of crispy on the outside, soft on the inside. For kofta, this is actually really, really different. This is really, really flavorful. Mm. Look at these little guys. Mmm. These sarma, the leaves on them are so fresh. They almost have a bit of an extra kind of texture to them than usual. They're really, really nice. And you can see the rice in there. I think I saw a bit of red pepper or something as well. Ooh. These are so fresh and really, really tasty. They're nice little small ones. Our manti have arrived with a lovely side of fresh bread that they make here, and it was so cool getting to watch the whole process of how they make them. So it's almost like a little bit of a pasta ravioli. Each one is packed with lamb meat with yogurt and Aleppo pepper on top. These little guys look amazing, and they're so teeny tiny. There's so much skill that goes into making the manti. Look at these little guys. They are so cute. They smell amazing. Mmm. Mmm. Oh, the lamb meat inside is so lovely. It tastes like there's also some spices in there with it as well. Really, really tasty. And there's so many you can fit on your spoon. So it's like a whole little mouth explosion of a bunch of different little manti. What a treat. What a skill to make these. Made with love. Mmm. So you can see the lovely lamb meat in there. Even though it's just a little bit, that's all you need. It's so flavorful, and when you get a bunch in your mouth at one time, so tasty. And the Aleppo pepper on it as well gives it a nice kick. Mmm. And the lamb is so tasty with the yogurt too. Such a nice mixing of flavors. The lamb and yogurt always work so well together. Mmm. Super light, really, really fresh. Nice with the yogurt. Pairs really, really good with the manti. You can really taste in the dough itself how fresh these manti are, and you can see the amount of work and effort that goes into making them. And not just one, but this whole bowl, there's so many in there. But honestly, these manti are seriously so amazing, like really, really good. I am loving these so much right now. The lovely owners here have been so friendly and so smiley ever since we arrived. It's been such a delicious, wonderful experience here. If you are ever in Izmir and you're craving manti, definitely come to Idil Manti EV for your manti fix.
We hope you've enjoyed our food adventure around Izmir today. If you have, give the video a like and make sure you share it with anyone you know who may like it as well. And make sure you subscribe to our channel to see more fun videos like this one. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.